everyone, I'm Sarah, one half of the YA room, and Merry Christmas! Whether or not you celebrate Christmas or Hanukkah or any other religious celebrations, or whether you kind of celebrate it more as a commercial holiday, or you're just enjoying the summer and the festive season, I hope you're having a lovely time. Wherever you are in the world, I hope this month has been great for you. I hope you've been celebrating and doing lots of fun stuff and spending time with your family and friends and just making the most of whatever's left of 2017. Though to be fair, 2017 has not been the best year in terms of like the whole world, whatever's going on. But I have high hopes for 2018 and just fingers crossed, there's gonna be great new releases, we're gonna get a whole ton of more books, and if nothing else is good in the world, at least we have that. But today I just wanted to do a little Christmas inspired video with a twist. No longer is it called Christmas anymore. I want to introduce you to Queersmas. Queersmas. That's right, we're celebrating everything queer, including me. Love me, celebrate me, validate me, all that good stuff. Just kidding. Today I want to share my top 5 queer Love Us YA books, and I hope you enjoy. First up, I have Ida by Alison Evans. It kind of feels like we've come full circle now. This was our very first book of the month at the YA room, and now I'm talking about it almost a year later. This time last year, the YA room was just a hopeful experiment, and don't get emotional. It just means so much to me to be back here a year later, and it's still a thing, and it's going so well, and yeah, it just means a lot to me. I said don't get emotional, and look what's happened. So Ida. This book is about a queer girl who's in a relationship with a genderqueer person, but it's also so much more than that. It's about parallel universes and doppelgangers, and if you love Doctor Who or you love specfic, this is the book for you. Also, it's queer, so like, go read it. The next book I have to share with you all for Queersmas is Night Swimming by Steph Bow. This book is absolutely gorgeous. It's set in a small town and we have a queer female protagonist who falls in love with this new girl, and it's just like adorable. It also faces tougher issues like sexuality in a small town and mental illness and friendship, and it's just a whole big ball of like gooey warm, like it's just so great. This isn't just queer fluff, but that is what I love it for. It's just so, so cute. If you're looking for a fun, sweet read this summer, definitely pick up Night Swimming. Queer girls are my life. Next up, I have a book written by Australia's own gay icon. I called it, he's an icon, Will Kostakis with The Sidekicks. This book is about grief and loss and friendship and coming together, but it's also about a queer boy. If you love Adam Silvera, then you definitely have to pick up The Sidekicks. It's just so gorgeous. It's so heartbreaking. It's so, so powerful. I just love it so much, and Will Kostakis is amazing. He is bae. Hashtag love Will YA. The next book I have to share with you for Queersmas is The Flywheel by Erin Goff. This was the very first queer novel I've ever read, and it means so much to me. This book is about a queer girl who works in a cafe, and it's about her best friend and this girl that she falls in love with. It's super cute. It is one of my favorite books ever, and it's just a must read. It's the first book that got me swooning over female-female relationships, and it's just adorable, and I love it so much, so much. Go read it. And the final book I have to share with you today is Queens of Geek by Jen Wilde. Oh look, it matches my top. How adorable. This book is one of my favorites of 2017. It was just phenomenal. This book is about a group of friends who go to a convention in America, and it's about their friendship and them exploring their sexuality and what that means in the community they're in. And it's just like, it's just so great. It's just so great, trust me. If you love conventions, or if you consider yourself a resident of the internet and you spend hours upon hours on Twitter and Tumblr and Instagram and have no actual life like me, then this is a must read. It's adorable. The romance is just gorgeous. There's so much positivity in this book. There's body positivity. There's talks about anxiety. And wow, I can't even. It's just so good. If you're yet to pick up this book, like, do it immediately. Drop what you're doing. Drop all these festive New Year plans. Just go pick it up. Well, I hope you enjoyed my top 5 picks for Queersmas, and if you're yet to read any of them, I definitely recommend checking them out. But now I'd love to hear from you. Have you read any of the books that I've mentioned? Do you have any other favourite queer Love Oz YA novels? How's your bingo challenge going? Have you enjoyed our month of Love Oz YA goodness? I'd love to know. Bye everyone!